Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. So we met again. That's what I call a true love. Yes, a true love for me, for XLOOKUP. I know you are here for another XLOOKUP. Don't worry, this time we have something really interesting for you. What do you say, Faraz?
Yes, Zenzo, definitely we are having a really interesting video today. And today we are going to talk about how to make an aging report in Excel.
Ah, smart boy. Very, very smart. I love your style, my friend.
So in the aging report, we will be seeing that how can we find the age of a specific payment which is overdue, or a specific delivery which is overdue for the delivery. So you can get that, categorize it, so you know where you have to focus first. So this is our data set over here, and we have the list of all the pending payments over here. Those could be overdue, those could be non-overdue also. And we have the age category table over here, this which I have prepared it. If something goes about 10 days, then it should fall between 11 to 60 days, and something about 90 days, then it should fall about 90 days. Now to get that result and put it into an XLOOKUP function, we would first need to extract the number of days the payment has been delayed. So let's do that. We will be adding a column called payment age category, and now we will be simply minusing today date minus the payment date. So basically the today is a volatile function, so every time we will generate this report, so that number has to get changed. Equals to days, I'll be using the function called days, and the end date is today date, comma, the start date is my payment date, and close parentheses, enter. Wonderful, so we got the number of days the payment has got delayed. Now with this number, we are going to pull the information from the age category, which means this number is our lookup value. So this is a very important number. So as you can see, there are orders in the list which goes above 90 days. So we would like to pull that information in the payment age category. So let's do it with the help of the XLOOKUP. So let's go and edit the formula just by adding XLOOKUP. So XLOOKUP, yes, this is my lookup value, the number 39, which we have seen earlier, comma, we'll be looking it into the age column. So that's the beauty of having your data in Excel table. It will automatically expand the range for you if the new data comes up. Comma, the return array. Of course, the return array is the age category which we are expecting to return back. Comma, and now this is a really interesting part. Over here, we are just simply going to say exact match or the next smaller item. Close parentheses. Smart boy. This time I know. If you hit enter, this will work fine without any problem. Brilliant guy. You are an awesome guy. That's great. So we got all our category names over here. But if you see, there are still NAs in our results. This is because, let me take you one step back. It is because those payments are not yet overdue. So that's the reason we are getting NA and we don't have any category over here. So we can just wrap that error into an if error and call it as a blank. So if error, and if any error is there, call this as a blank value. So now our column looks little neat and clean. Let us assume that we have to add another age category, which is between 31 to 60 days. Now to handle that, we will just simply go to our age table and we will say 31, and we will call this as 31 to 60 days, and we have to change this now to 30 days. Because if something goes above 30 days, then it will fall under category of 31 to 60 days, and similarly the other categories as well. Now you don't have to even worry about sorting your data into ascending or descending order, because XLOOKUP will do that for you. Let's add another category, which is minus 15 days, and that category we will call as next payment 15 days. So this report will help us to do some analysis. So let us quickly make a pivot table of this one and see how it will look. And we can just simply use this new feature, which is ideas. So ideas basically will take your data to the Microsoft AI engine and suggest you the best match for your data. So let us look over here some matches we have. See if we have, yes, this sounds interesting for me. So it says me that the payment age category between 61 to 90 for the best choice and fast reading, noticeable and higher amount. So yes, this is what we can use it. And if I will add insert pivot chart, it will automatically make the pivot chart and the pivot table for me. So here we have it. So I can just simply close this ideas and I can just play around with my data over here. The AI engine is so cool that it will just do the job for you and give it for you, and your report is ready all the way in your hand. So if you like to do your own analysis and we would not need this chart, then we can just simply delete it and go to filter payment age category. We can put them into the rows and we can put the suppliers into columns, and let us remove the filters from the rows. So clear all the filter. Now with this data, we can easily add some slicers. So that will allow us to slice and dice the data and see which are the customers having the payment overdue for the maximum time. Smart boy, very, very smart. For us, your Excel tips are really cool. Now with this data, I know fast service is doing very slow service. With my payments, is having the most of my outstanding payment. So I can focus on those guys. Robert, get all my horses ready. We have a job to do. And you guys, don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments how you like this video. And we will be coming up soon with more amazing tips and tricks. Until then, bye. Take care. Sayonara. Love you guys.